And now to our week-long look at how generous donations from you, our viewers, help so many families in need during the holidays. On Friday, we are asking you to share your holiday with Central Coast families as we team up with the Salvation Army to collect money, toys, clothing, and food. Action News reporter Mei Chow has more.
Last June, 13-year-old Elizabeth Rangel was diagnosed with leukemia, and it's just been over a year since she's received her bone marrow transplant. She's off chemotherapy now, but her body rejected the transplant, and Elizabeth has to go to Stanford Medical Center three times a week for treatment. Elizabeth's mom, Anna, says her daughter doesn't talk about the cancer or complain about the pain.
She is strong. All the time, she's always been strong. With everything that's happened, how should I say this? Instead of me supporting her, she supports me.
And her strength comes partly from the women she's met at the Salvation Army.
Pues he conocido a muchas señoras y ya grandes de edad.
I have met a lot of women, older women. Here, what I do is help decorate and do a lot of activities.
Anna has been coming to the Salvation Army every Wednesday for the past 6 years to participate in one of the family programs. She started bringing Elizabeth after her cancer diagnosis, and Elizabeth says she finds comfort here through friendship and prayer.
I pray that I can get better and so that I can help other kids that are going through the same thing that I am.
Anna says the Salvation Army in Watsonville has given Elizabeth some peace of mind.
Help people lift their spirits, and if you have something to give, donate and help other families.
And it's also helped Anna's family. The Rangels moved from King City to Watsonville so they could be closer to Stanford Hospital. But the rent is higher, and with her husband having to take time off of work to help care for Elizabeth and his three other children, the family was getting behind with their bills.
Un poco preocupada porque no...
I was worried because I didn't have anything to get my kids' toys with.
The Salvation Army paid for the Rangel's PG&E bill last month and is hoping to do much more for the family.
Thank you to the Salvation Army. They have made this Christmas so different.
The need is greater in this part of the county, so we are trying to do as much as we can do to help out.
Officer Robert Vickes says if there ever were a time to give, it's now. More than 200 families have already signed up for food, toys, and clothes this Christmas, and Vickes says he may end up having to take money out of his own pocket to make sure no one walks away without help, especially Elizabeth and her family.
This is a special family who needs special attention, and we have to do our best to do that. So we are pleading to the community they can help us this season to make it happen.
And that was Mei Chow reporting for us tonight. Your donations help so many families here on the Central Coast. So don't forget, our annual Share Your Holiday event is set for this Friday. It's happening this Friday. Action News will be with the Salvation Army at locations throughout the Central Coast. We've got 5 drop-off locations, including in Capitola at Toyota in the Auto Mall, in Hollister at Fire Station Number 2, here in Salinas at our studios on John Street, at Granite Rock on Del Monte in Seaside, and in Watsonville at Giant Berry Cooling on Industrial Road. You can drop off donations, including non-perishable food, new clothes, wrapped toys, as well as cash and, as always, frozen turkeys. It is a wonderful event, a wonderful way to give during this holiday season, and we certainly hope that you'll join us this Friday.